and welcome back to the garden. Today I wanted to show you a couple little things you could do in your own backyard. Back when we had Katrina come through, this area used to be full of pine trees, and we had all those cleared out because they broke and it looked really bad. We had them taken out, and once they did that, we tried to keep some of the hardwoods. So once we had some of the hardwoods here, I had a natural gully that comes down through the middle of my yard. And what I did was I had my husband build me a bridge, and we set it here. And I got to looking, and I wanted a dry creek bed. I have a well, so you know, I wouldn't be able to use water very much. So I built a dry creek bed. And the way I did that is this is a lower area, and I dug it all out and throwed it up to the sides of the bank. And I added rocks along the edges, and I planted some flowers. So I wanted to show you what your garden could look like if that's all you did is dig out one little area that could be a dry creek bed. You would just put gravel or river rocks in it, just whatever you like to do. And so I'm going to show you a few of the flowers I planted in it. Okay, here I have a dianthus, and it's got a really beautiful blue color to it, and it is the dianthus fire witch. It's beautiful, blooms in the spring with fuchsia hot pink flowers that stand up about this tall on it. They've already bloomed out, so I trimmed them off. This is a hypericum calcineum, and it's only been in the ground for a couple of years, and I haven't really noticed it doing a whole lot yet, but it's living, and I'm really liking it. And this one is a variety of an evergreen blueberry. It's kind of new. I put it in the ground, and I'm just going to see what it's going to do. But I really do like it. I don't see any blueberries on it yet, but I don't think it's an edible blueberry. There is a type of a cedar. It's called Glacier Blue, and it's supposed to only get about 4 feet tall, and it's got a really nice blue color to him. I love it. So I planted it here at the end of the flower bed that sits low. I really don't want anything to get too tall, but 4 feet is 4 feet's pretty good. Now in this area, this is called a penstemon, a red rocks penstemon. The flower is actually purpley pink, and hummingbirds absolutely love it. It is a perennial, and I've been really pleased with it since I don't get to water because I do live on a well. This one has really done good. He's only been in the ground a year, and he's already this big. It was a 1 gallon plant. And beside it, I planted a sage. It's called Black and Blue, which is not blooming yet, but it is one of the bluest blues that you can get in the landscape. It kind of tends to lean towards a dark, dark blue. But I've got that with this pink, and these are my white Shasta daisies. And I think the color is going to look really pretty. I've got a little bit of garden art out here. My little frogs. And you can see the red verbena. I've planted some red verbena. And that over there in the background is your hypericum calcineum again. I just want to see how that's going to do. A few other little things that we've got out here is going to be this little plant right here. This is a veronica, one of the veronicas called Georgia Blue. It is extremely blue, and it blooms in February, so it's one of your very first flowers to bloom. It is a perennial, and it'll just trail down over the rocks here. Here we have another area, and this is a type of verbena right here. It is called Shaw Verbena, and I love it. It is a perennial, and I think it looks really pretty out here in the garden. Then beside it, I've got some dianthus. Here's the dianthus. And I just gave it a haircut the other day, so it'll hopefully keep on blooming. And in the background over there, we have a type of rudbeckia. That one gets about 6 feet tall, and it will have yellow flowers on it with a very large brown cone. And it'll be absolutely gorgeous. It is a perennial. I put a grass out there in the little tub, and it'll bloom later on in the fall. This little yellow flower is called a ternaria, or that's what I purchased it as. I've never grown one, but I'm going to see how it goes this year. And that little flower near the turtle is one of your Gerber daisies. Absolutely gorgeous addition to your garden. And as long as your soil is pretty decent, they will come back year after year. And it is a perennial. Here we have a gomphrena, or the gomphrena globosa, and it's just a little round flower. Absolutely gorgeous. It is an annual, but it adds a spots of color to your garden, just like the red verbena. I have my butterfly in my garden. And here's another angle of my little garden where I dug it out. And as you can see, along the edges, there's the rocks that I lined the edge with. That gives it a nice creek bed look to it, even though it is a dry creek bed. Our water does roll down the yard and naturally goes to this area. So just keep that in mind if you have an area where water naturally goes or runs down. That would be a good area for your creek bed. Well, I hope you've enjoyed the show today. It's just a few little things you can do in your own yard. And I hope you enjoy yourself while you're out there doing it. And keep in mind to plant plants that are going to be drought tolerant. And I think you'll really enjoy it. So thanks again for watching our show, and see you next time.